Good evening. Welcome to this edition of the 411 Talk Zone Radio Show. My name is Leon Jones. Tonight, I'm going to get into my Black History series once again. This time, I'm going to talk about a gentleman by the name of Mr. Philip Downing. Now, despite the fact that the art of letter writing has been lost to this modern society, we still all seem to make use of letterboxes. Now, what I mean by letterbox, we're talking about a mailbox or post boxes, often outside of our homes. In America in particular, the image of a steel box standing on some kind of pillar or structure is synonymous with getting the paper, collecting bills, or if you have a wild streak, practical jokes. The icon of telecommunications culture has brought us everything from devastating war letters to love letters, and the inventor of the device, as we know, was an African-American man by the name of Philip Downing. Like so many African-American inventors, very little is known about Downing's personal life. He lived during the middle to late 1800s, and he obviously had a practical mind, as two of his patents managed to become crucial inventions. His first patent came in 1890 when he designed a switch system to be used on railroads as part of planning and guiding trains along the track. This contribution was an early prototype for the light switch as we know today. 1 year later, his famous design, and this is his most famous design, is the street letterbox. It was patented. It featured a steel box with a hanging door, which was supported by four legs. The idea was thought that by having a letterbox in front of your home, you would not have to go down to the local post office to send and receive mail. This idea single-handedly revolutionized the way in which people communicated at that time and also made life far easier for mail personnel. It takes a brief second of inspiration to change the course of human history, and thanks to the works of minds like Philip Downing's, our lives can run the course of convenience that they do today. Let me talk about this invention, Mr. Philip Downing. And there are other inventions out there as well. In fact, the potato chip was also created by African Americans, but the mailbox. And that is true. A number of us don't write letters because we can utilize email by scanning a document to the computer and just sending it via email. But you have to remember, the post office is still running its business. In fact, the worst thing I hate about the post office is they're running broke, but they keep raising the price of stamps. But going back to this synonymous invention by Mr. Philip Downing, I'm talking about the mailbox. The big mailbox with the handle on it. It stands on four legs. It's red, white, and blue. And you see it on some street corners. You see it in front of convenience stores. I know. I use them. It was a great invention. And again, I'm looking at a gentleman with a bright mind. Mr. Downing didn't have a lot of education. And I'm starting to think that education is all a ruse. Because the inventions that I talk about come from common sense. People actually just thinking up of an idea to help revolutionize society, make it convenient for human beings to have a better life. You have to realize when we talk about the post office in those days, and again, a lot of these inventions have come along in the late 19th century into the 20th century, and that's because of the Industrial Revolution, because prior to that, you had the cotton gin that was invented by Eli Lilly, and that was invented to help pick cotton make it easy. But when you have an idea like a mailbox, who would ever think that a mailbox, even in 2017, would be synonymous to American society? And it's true. A number of us do not write letters anymore. However, the post office is still being utilized. Why? We type letters. Another thing, we drop mail into the mailbox. And I can go right down the street. I live here in Portage, Indiana, to the Speedway. Speedway is a gas station like the East Coast Wawa, which I'm from the East Coast, and they have them sitting outside of their convenience stores as well, 7-Elevens, malls. You go to any store or any strip mall, you'll find a steel mailbox. It'll tell you what time the mail is collected, red, white, and blue. Now, what's upsetting is I don't hear that Mr. Philip Downing got any credit. This was his patent, but why isn't he mentioned? This is where I have a problem with the media and why black people need to come together to establish our own media. Also, we need to have more African-American or black history studies in not just HBCUs, but also regular colleges, because now you have an influx of African-Americans attending the bigger schools, so they're not going to HBCUs as much, although you still have a number of HBCUs such as Morehouse, Langston University, still operating in service. But what I'm trying to get to you is that when you create an invention that everybody is using today, the gentleman who was at the forefront should be mentioned. And let me tell you, brother, something. If you believe that black men in the past didn't do anything, think again. Because again, I'm trying to get to the younger generation, because some of you still have this idea that you're living in all this comfort, but you don't know where all of the ideas came from. They didn't come from you. Because a number of you don't want to bring up any ideas. The gentlemen and the ladies that I've mentioned during Black History Month should give you an example of what black people have contributed to this country, even without the benefit of having any type of college education. But a number of us can go to college. We go to work. We might not get the same amount of money as our white counterparts, but you know what? We have better living conditions today than Mr. Philip Downing did. But Mr. Philip Downing and others that I've talked about here on YouTube managed to get over the hump during racist societies, the Ku Klux Klan. Somehow, these gentlemen found a way. And I always tell everybody that failure means you just have to get back up and learn where you didn't aspire. And what you do, you go back and try again. You ever heard that old saying, if you don't succeed, try again? When you invent any type of product, it's basically trial and error. You must set up a prototype and test it. And that's what the mailbox is. Now, most of us, particularly if you live in apartments, the idea of any mailbox came from the big mailbox that you see on four legs. That's outside the post office, outside all of your convenience stores. And see, back in the days, mail was delivered by horses. So you imagine how important or significant the mailbox is and was. I mean, today all you have to do is go open the mailbox, put it in that white box, carry it to the post office, distribute it, and it goes out. In the past, you were on horses. Now, again, the towns, when it came to mail, were much smaller than they are now, so you didn't have as much mail to deliver. But regardless, when you look at any product that an African American, whether male or female, patented, it should be recognized. This is where reward comes from. And this is what I tell individuals why we as African Americans need to understand our history. Because those who came before us with their practical ideas, they offered their product to everybody, regardless of race. I mean, who would ever thought that you would hear Mr. Philip Downing in a mailbox? They called it a letterbox, but it's a mailbox. And that letterbox is synonymous today. You see, I enjoy all these inventions because what you are now beginning to understand is that it doesn't take a complex equation to design any type of product. It just takes a thought. Now, of course, you need to know how to set up your prototype. But if you believe that you have any invention, get a patent. See if it works. I mean, a super soaker is a fantastic invention, and you still sell them today. And a super soaker is a high-powered water gun. You know how old that product is? Goes back to 1991. Now, we're in 2017 now. That's 26 years old. That's not even young. That's not even old. It's young. 26 years old. But the gentleman and I went over his invention of that super soaker, and he did other inventions as well. And basically, when I introduce an inventor, they do more than one patent, but I go over the biggest achievement. Because in society, without the likes of the mailbox, think about it, where would we be? Because from that design of the red, white, and blue mailbox. And it wasn't red, white, blue back then. You had some that were green. You had some that were gray with black letters. And then you had the blue ones. But that mailbox went from the four-legged mailbox that you see out on the street to, if you go in apartment complexes, you got clusters of mailboxes. If you live in rural areas, doing on rural routes, you've got a certain type of mailbox, and it, guess what? They all do the same thing. Some may utilize keys, but some, you just open the handle, put the letter in, and drive away. Those are mailboxes. Came from the same concept. And that's what I'm telling you about products that are always invented. They improve as time goes on because there's more information on how the product works. But let me get back to what we have to do as African Americans. And also on Black History Month, I have to put out this information to some of my white brothers and sisters as well. Because, you know, inventions come from all people. But I primarily stick to Black History Month because I don't believe that African Americans get their just due because of the media that we have today and the media that we have in the past. So I have come up with this idea to continue to produce information by naming some of these African American brothers and sisters who were able to achieve by utilizing patents, having their own businesses, and creating products that we still use today. And I want to bring that to everyone's attention, because in the African-American community today, we are lacking any type of commitment, and we're not willing to change from the society of being victims. Certainly, does racism exist? Does white supremacy exist? And what I mean by white supremacy, I'm not talking about all white people. I'm talking about white people who have the majority of the influence and power because they have most of the money. So they can utilize their resources to influence decisions by the government. That's all I'm saying. Because, again, white supremacy just doesn't affect minorities. It also affects lower class white people as well. That's why I did that video on racism and classism, which in actuality are the same. Because it's the elites who are running this country. But to my black brothers and sisters out there, sit back, respect yourself, number one. Number two, understand your role in society as an adult. Number three, get an education. Number four, be respectful. Respect your elders, because your elders are part of the rank and file structure. In the military, you're not going to be a private and you're going to disrespect the full bird colonel. It's not going to happen. And in order for those principles to work, you must go back and understand what prior generations did. Certainly, every generation makes mistakes, but every generation has the good that we should be talking about as well. And the millennials, they create this new technology every year. That's also significant. I mean, I could tell you when I was coming up, and I graduated from high school in 1983, which is 34 years ago. It's not that long ago. However, I was still using a slide rule. Then the calculator came out. It got better. I remember 8-track tapes. They were on their way out. Then the cassettes came in. And they went out. Then records. Records would crack. Well, they went out. Then you had a big laser disc that came in. And that was prior to the CD player. You had the Walkman, which was a regular tape recorder. And an AM/FM radio that went out. Then you had the CD version. So when it comes to any product, the products that are still around withstand time. And the mailbox that Mr. Philip Downing invented is still around today. And you know what? It's always going to be around. It's a classic. And that's what you have to understand. You have some businesses that come and go, but the ones that are still around are classics. Why? Because they know how to continue to market themselves. This is why they'll never go out of business. Like, look at McDonald's. McDonald's has been around for nearly 70 years. And they know how to keep up with the times. You look at the mailbox. The mailbox has been around for over 100 years because the design keeps being improved. But I'm just trying to get all my black brothers and sisters to understand that you're worth more, particularly women. I'm going to talk to you sisters right now. Sisters, you're beautiful. You're worth more than your hips and your thighs. Brothers, you're worth more than getting out here thugging, being irresponsible, staying at home while your woman works. That's not a man. And then you want to get bossy because your woman is doing more than you, but you really feel bad about yourself. And this is what's wrong with the African-American community now. People who succeed in the African-American community, they don't want to come back to the so-called hood. because the individuals still in the hood aren't willing to wake up themselves. Now, some can't get out, but some can. But you got to be motivated to do anything in life. And again, to have an invention, it takes work. If you don't do the work, but complain, then guess what? That means you will never do the work. See, it's easier to criticize someone from the sidelines, but it's hard to be a soldier, because soldiers are making that sacrifice. They're doing that work. But if you understand what each and every inventor had to go through during a time of racism, you should have a much better respect for yourselves as African Americans. And do you know, I didn't even know about Mr. Philip Downing until I did research on him. And now, the more I do these videos during Black History Month, now I understand what I've been missing. And this is what I'm talking about. There's a lot of information out there. Just because you believe that it doesn't exist, or it does exist, you have to find it. That's the difference. You have to dig deep. Because basically when you go below the surface, that's when you find what you need. So I just want you, brothers and sisters, to take time to understand that we're more than what is being described about us in the media. And at the end of the day, give this inventor, Mr. Philip Downing, his just due. Because, again, without the mailbox, we wouldn't have that convenience of utilizing his product to deliver our mail. We'd have to go to the post office. And this product is very good, particularly if you live in a city and you don't have a car. So you thank him for the wonderful mailboxes that we have. And also with the mailbox, it's more of a convenience to get your letters out on time and delivered to the proper destination on time. And then when you're expecting something back, it comes back to you on time. That's what you have to understand about Mr. Philip Downing's invention, the mailbox. And appreciate it. Because at the end of the day, if you don't appreciate it, you may come up with something that's going to help society out. And you're going to want your appreciation. So remember, millennial generation, appreciate what, and I'm talking to the African American community, appreciate what these forefathers known as Black inventors did for all of us. Because you too are going to invent something, and you are going to want the future generations to read about you. Because inventions create conscious minds. Lastly, let me put this out. When you look at what's going on in the African American community, we can do what we put our minds to. We allow ourselves to be taken for a ride based on our color, but we don't have to. That's why we need our own economy. Again, respect Mr. Philip Downing, because he put one piece of the puzzle in the place that everybody uses. That's known as the mailbox. And that's my commentary for this edition of the 411 Talk Zone radio show for this evening, Saturday, February 25th, 2017. You can tune into the 411 Talk Zone radio show every Monday from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. on Blog Talk Radio. Guest call-in number is 215-383-5785. And if you like my videos, please share and subscribe to the 411 Talk Zone radio show so I can continue to give you quality information for educational purposes from a professional and mature perspective. Now, on this channel, I don't engage in debates, emotional, or controversial issues, nor do I participate in drama or unnecessary bickering. This channel is specifically for educational purposes only, where I bring you topics from business, education, careers, and politics. But if I utilize any social issues, I'm going to break down the information thoroughly and utilize it to educate you. So remember, knowledge is power. And if you have a business or a topic or a new YouTube channel that you would like for me to discuss on Blog Talk Radio or YouTube, please email me at lej6521@gmail.com. And if you want to leave a comment, and I do read my comments, leave your comment in the comment section under the video. But you must make your comments pithy. No bloviating, pettifogging, or filibustering if you wish to opine. Now on to the shoutouts. Shout out to my main man, B-Hat. You check him out, it's tax season at taxpeople.com. Shout out to Brother Tobias, O'Shea Duke Jackson. Shout out to Conscious Effort, check his channel out. Rashawn DeLay, Karen Kennedy, Sandy Pooh, Warren Williams, Brother DC, Devlon Chapman. Shout out to Reg the Bad Guy, the real deal from Gary, Indiana. I hear you, brother. Big Body Matt Coley, and Matt, you did a fantastic job with educating your buddy there in front of the Amazon building in Camden, New Jersey, how to ride a bike the first time. I caught that 51 seconds that you presented. Also, you want to check out Matt Big Body Coley's channel. He's doing trucking. And of course, Matt bought himself a bike as well. Check his channel out. Check out Q Wilson if you want some information about Uber. He'll get it done. Also, you want some real positive information, check out Felicia in the Healing Palace. And good cooking. I saw her channel. Matter of fact, I saw her on Reg the Bad Guy's channel. Her name is Mrs. G. Check out Mrs. G's cooking show, Green. And last but not least, check out Brother Angry Man's channel. And, of course, let me throw in Ringo TV Raw. And I'll be adding more to the shout-out list because I want each and every YouTuber to support each other, regardless of what you are delivering in your content, as long as it's educational. Because, again, it's very important that we have our own media in the African-American community. That way we can establish our own standard of beauty and our own standards. Because what I'm doing with my channel, I'm trying to get us to understand what our identity is instead of someone else telling us what our identity should be. Because African-American people, we are your thinkers and inventors. We just didn't have the mind to understand copyrights, trademarks, and patents. But once you watch my videos and you like my videos, you'll get a good education. Because I want to make sure that all of us in the African-American community are taught. Because you don't want to run around ignorant, because you will be treated ignorantly. And when I mean ignorant, misinformation. So I'm going to keep filling your glass with that information, because I know you're thirsty for this knowledge. And that's it for this video. Till next time, my name is Leon Jones. Remember, please be gentle and respectful to each other, and have a wonderful and blessed night. Good night.